Okay, so we're going to have a look at this kind of step-on-step propeller, where we walk the steps like this and turn them like so. And this can happen equally is the horizontal. No, I'm here.
Yeah, it's fine.
So for this,
okay.
I hold on to the base staff obviously, and I'm going to put my fingers out and my thumb out. And I'm going to hold it just below the set point. And I'm going to put the staff, the contact staff, on the outside away from me. So this is like a little bar, a cage, keeping it away from me. And then my hands like this. So in this, my knuckles are always facing the same direction, all the time, no matter where I grab the staff. My hands are always with the knuckles like this. Never like this, always like this. And I can hold the contact staff between my fingers as I rotate it. But once you get the moves, you won't have to do that. So now I've rotated it onto the other hand. And obviously I can go back me, but that's not what this is about. This is a
bicycle.
So now I have to reach under and grab again. So this is the tricky bit, reaching under. So now I have. So this is like an easy transfer.
Corkscrew downwards, front balance.
And then this one, this is my left hand. And then do the dive through. Is it doing over there? Has to go under my right.
Yeah.
Come around.
What about that one that happened where you were standing up on hands and rises?
So that one needs to go through our hand. Yeah, it just it drops you down to the bone shelf.
Like so.
So it goes through that.
Now equally, I can do this on the inside.
Yeah, maybe.
So now the contact staff is on the inside of the base staff towards me. And that works as well, exactly the same.
Yeah.
Whoa, it's a little bit different actually.
Yeah,
keep going. Doesn't really happen so good horizontally. Horizontally, again, you can obviously bend the planes up the top, but in this situation, we're just going to go up here, and here we've got the same thing happening. Hands, knuckles. This one.
Let's do that whole sequence.
You always grab the staff closest to you, which is the base staff. Never grab this one, because then this one comes down and hits you on the head. Always grab the base staff because it's the one stopping the contact staff hitting you in the face. Okay, good to know. Good to know. Knuckles always facing the same direction.
No, exactly. Especially
a little bit easier to hold the contact staff on the base staff to get that twist so that your arms can cross and we grab. Like so. So you can see if you want to go back into other step and step contact moves, you can just grab the base staff like you normally would and let it come back out. I'm the same in the entrance. The entrance is from the very simple pirouette style move, from any like the typewriter style ones. Oh god, what's going to happen? Oh my god. So here, I can go in, and then I close my hands up and I'm into the move. And again, on the way out, I present my hands like this, and then wait for the contact staff to turn enough so that it starts rolling into the angle here, this trap area.
Okay, so
yeah, that makes sense.